All right, guys, we are back on the Sky Factory server. And Tim, what is this tree?
I don't know what this tree is. Actually, I do know. This is the rubber tree, and this rubber tree is amazing. It's the basis of the Mine Factory Reloaded mod, and from it, you get rubber saplings, but also whenever you chop this tree down, check this out. You get these wonderful little things. They look like teardrops.
Nice.
Yeah, but this rubber is the basis for every single machine in the Mine Factory Reloaded pack. So everything that you make in Mine Factory Reloaded, you're going to use this rubber to craft plastic sheets and all those other fun things. I mean, Mine Factory Reloaded is a very easy way to make all sorts of cool machines for automating, like planting. Actually, whenever we get animals from birth to death, it'll breed them, it'll take care of them, it'll nurture them until they get older, and then it'll kill them so you can eat them. And slaughter farms, and actually have some machines for energy and all sorts of things.
Nice.
It's a fun mod.
I'm looking forward to that. But before we get there, we gotta get some cobblestone and we gotta get some lava going.
We gotta do a lot of stuff.
Yes. Such as modded Minecraft and Sky Factory.
Yes, for sure.
All right. So I have a fired clay bucket here we made off camera. And it has been 7 days since the rain had been going. So should we be honest with them?
Sure.
We decided to do toggle down or fall. What is it? Toggle downfall?
Toggle downfall.
So we did get water so that we could have that going. All right, let's see. We want. Do you use the rubber wood for anything besides getting the rubber?
It actually becomes jungle wood.
Right.
So yeah, you don't really use it for anything, and it makes three planks instead of four.
Right.
So it's like you kind of lose when you use it, but.
So I'm gonna use the jungle wood to create the infinite water source then.
Yeah, that'll work.
Okay. Oops. All right, so let me get this going, and then I'll show you how I made the pot. So let's see, right here. We'll just have to expand this out later, but that's okay. And then, typical thing. Beautiful. Now I can fill these back up. All right, so if we go ahead and I guess we need a cobblestone. So we gotta get some dirt over here. And then we sift this. Get some stones to make some cobblestone. Beautiful. And I'm not doing this just for the sake of doing it. We do need more clay.
Yes, we do.
So we got some clay here. That's what it looks like, just typical clay. I'm going to turn this into sand. Excellent. Actually, I'm going to save one of these so that we can check off our achievement book.
Yay.
To sift sand. There we go. And what do we get? Nothing. It did it again. It gave me nothing. Oh, I just used the dust on the sieve.
Oh, no.
We got bone meal, so that's not bad.
Well, there you go.
Whoops. All right, let's try that again. Get some leaves. Make me some dirt. Go. Pop. So what are you doing over there?
I am making just a real simple dark space so we can hopefully get some skeleton spawning in here so we can get some bone meal. You can make a more efficient mob spawner, and you've got a really good design for that. But this is just a real simple way to get things going early on, just okay. A nice dark room. And that way we can get to moving on our things that we need to do.
What are some things that we need the bone meal for?
Oh, man. Well, pretty much for the crucible.
Yep.
And that way, once we get the crucible going, we can start making the porcelain clay, start making the lava. That's fantastic.
Oops, I don't think I needed that much. Here we go. Trying to make some compacted crooks. There we go. Boom. So we're going to just put kind of a little generic vanilla mob farm over there.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Very generic. Very simple.
Now, is there any risk to that?
Oh, yeah, there's always risk. Creepers, you know, they like to blow up from time to time.
True.
And, yeah, I don't know if you knew that or not. So, yeah, they could blow up. Or if, you know, you're doing this, you're not paying attention, you accidentally vein mine everything, you could accidentally vein mine this and fall to your death.
True. I almost did that when we had the other world and I was tearing yours down. I was standing on the edge after I had vein mined, so I was one block away from falling off.
So yes, oh, no. Happen. All right, we got a dark space.
Cool.
So we'll see if anything spawns in here.
Excellent. So here's what you do with the barrels. You got dust, just stick the dust in. And then you take the dust out, and this beautiful rain will keep firing off for us. And then you just take the clay, and there you go. So we got the clay.
Yay!
And we have 3 bone meal right now. So what we'll do is we'll need, I think it's 7, right?
7, yeah. 7 bone meal.
So you just stick 3 clay with 3 bone meal. And it creates porcelain clay, and then we'll make a U shape with it, and then that will help us make the crucible. And the reason that we need this crucible so bad, because that's why we're gonna get our lava. Anybody?
Yay!
Nobody yet. I'll walk away.
Walk away. It's like you can't stand there and look, or they'll never spawn.
Right.
We'll go over here.
Let's see. Need some more of these. Should I go ahead and switch to rubber trees now? Or should I keep doing this for the apples?
Let's see. We can, yeah.
Do you think we're going to be making a farm anytime soon?
Or... Yeah, I can do that next, actually.
Okay.
Once we get all
the bone meal. Okay. Oh, I see entities.
Oh, goodness. Got a sword.
Okay.
See what we got. I see feet moving. I see a lot of feet moving. What do we got in there? Yeah, we got a lot of things. Oh, there's a creeper there.
Just waiting for that. Oh, no!
Yeah.
Watch him killing over there.
Don't you blow. Don't you blow. Yeah, I got the creeper. All right. And let's see. What do we got? I got 6 bone meal.
Awesome.
All right. So let's take this thing apart so we don't do something silly. Torch. All right. Now all we have to do if we need that is remove the torch.
Cool. So I will build a mob farm off camera. It'll just be kind of an AFK one. Let me show you guys the vacuum hopper I'm going to use. Spelled vacuum wrong. So we got this little vacuum hopper. Requires an obsidian and a hopper and an eye of ender. The obsidian is actually really easy, even early game to use, because you just put some lava in one of our barrels over here, and then you put water on top of it, and it automatically creates obsidian for us. The hopper we'll have to get some iron for. I have ender. We'll have to get a couple of ender pearls and a blaze rod. So we'll have some stuff to do. Oops. Get rid of some of that. All right. So crucible. We need 4 more of these. Let's go ahead and do that. And then a U-shape. And we have our unfired crucible. I'm going to waste a whole charcoal. Just kidding. I'm going to
use it. don't waste the charcoal.
Make some more charcoal from charcoal. All right, so we got our fired crucible. Now what do I do with it?
Yeah, you set it over a torch.
Nice.
And then you throw some wonderful cobble in it. We got lava going.
Now, does it produce heat itself? Oh, my goodness, that was huge. Okay. So if I put it right here, it's actually okay?
Yeah, as long as it's over torch.
Okay. I just don't want it to
burn. I say that as it burns everything down.
yeah
we're good. That. We're good.
We're good. Oh, no. Just kidding. All right. So now we need some stone to put in there. And what happens is that torch is apparently hot enough. Now, I don't know if you know this, but if you put it over a furnace, it's actually twice as powerful. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Yeah. So we could just put it over. I don't know if this furnace counts. I'm assuming it does.
Does it have to be
a vanilla
one?
Does
it have to be moving? Yeah, on.
It does have to be burning.
Okay.
Whereas the torch itself does not have to be burning. So there is that distinction there.
So now once we get this lava going, what all can we do with it?
Well, first of all, you got a sweet cobblestone generator you're going to make. It's just a generic vanilla one. But apparently I don't know how to make them very well because you make them uber efficient. And and I don't mean that sarcastically. I mean, I do not know how to make them, and you make them really well.
Oh, and thank you.
And then we will go crazy with getting ores at that point.
That is right.
All right. So, come on, dirt. You can also put the silkworms in there. So I made 2 of them out of silkworms since we don't need a ton of silk now. Man, it's just this like, we're so close to getting some good lava and then a cobblestone generator. And then at that point, just AFK at the cobblestone generator and get some grinding there as well. That'll be a good time.
It will be a good time.
You think we'll be able to, you want to try to do the cobblestone generator on camera?
I sure can, if we want to.
Do you think the lava would create that quick if we can get it going? We got
if we can.
See, we'll at least get it set up and then just put the lava down.
We only need one.
Here's the bucket. Now those fired buckets, it gets consumed when you use lava, right?
Yes. Yep. You will lose it.
Lava goes first, and then or second, and then once you use the lava, it's done for. Can't use it; it disappears.
Okay, and to make the cobble generator, since we don't have much cobble up, we can use workbenches.
Yep.
And workbenches won't catch on fire.
Nice.
So it's a wonderful, wonderful way to get your cobble generator going, using the resources that you have early on, and we'll swap it out for the goodness later on, but as for right now, I'll just start with the workbenches.
Now, if they ever do upgrade Minecraft, that actually gets fixed in a later version of Minecraft itself.
Yeah.
So.
You know what version that gets fixed in?
I think it's the one right after this. So this is 7, okay. And I think it's the very next version, 1.8. Because this is 1.7.10, is that right? Or 9?
Yes, yeah.
Oh, zombie. And there's a skeleton over there.
You need help? I got a sword.
I'm just going to bounce him off. That skeleton, though.
I'll go get that skeleton.
Do you need a torch?
Right next to a torch. Hey, buddy. Bye-bye.
So if you use F7, you can actually see where you need to place the torches. You might have actually spawned up here.
On top of that, I think that's happened before. I think I've done that where I didn't put torches up there.
Hmm. Do you think it's on top of your mob farm too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Stack. I got some wood.
What was I doing again? Oh, I just turned everything. I had 5 cobblestone. I'm a nincompoop. I turned the cobblestone into dust. I'm rushing it. That's why I keep screwing up.
That's no good. Don't rush it.
All right. And boop. 4 cobblestone in there. And if you guys notice there, it says solid volume and fluid volume. The solid volume slowly going down. That is our cobblestone in there. And then you have that number at the top, the 278, 980. That's when our lava, if it gets to 1,000, then that's 1 bucket there. So we will have lava very soon.
We will, which is awesome.
Now it's currently, it says it's a 1x melting speed. Lava, I think, is a 2x. Is that right? Or a 2.5?
I really don't know.
And then there's actually higher liquids that you can use, including pythium. I don't remember how to say it. Anyways, there's another one that you can use that'll actually make it 7x. So if we ever want to get that far into it, we can make a 7x generator. Oh, and good news, we have blaze powder, so we can make that Eye of Ender.
Oh, awesome.
Dun, dun, dun. And just put torch up here. You think you got all the stuff on the mob farm good?
Yeah, it should be.
Okay.
I saw no yellow.
Cool. All right, so you got half slabs going there. We're at 500 millibuckets. Now, my guess is next time we see that chest over there, it's going to be much more organized because is it just you that you have a thing with organized chests?
it's me. It's also a mod that's built into the game.
Okay.
You just press the little button and it'll kind of organize the chests for you.
Is it R?
And yeah. Oops. Like when you flip into the chest.
Ooh, it didn't do
it. You see the... those little different buttons up in the top right corner.
Yeah, there we go.
And cool. I almost always, it's just kind of instinctual. I push one of those buttons.
Nice.
And it
I thought you were
of...
like slaving over the organization.
Yeah, I was. And I was always complaining. I was like, lies. Man, this Jeremy is always not doing anything to organize these chests, leaves them a mess.
The lies.
Yeah.
All right, so we got that going. The water's going to go in here. Now, what he does, is this just like the pro version of this? You have a hole in here?
Yeah, okay. Pretty much. It's the pro way. You know, it's my way. It's the pro way. you put the water right there, and then you put the lava right here. The water will drop down there. The lava sits there, and then your cobblestone will pop up right there.
Nice. We're almost to lava. Actually, it's showing lava, but I don't think it's actually lava yet.
No bucket. Well, I'll go ahead and get the water going.
Cool. Will be right perfect. That once we get that lava going, that we will be at time. So talk about... Ooh. We clearly did that. Clearly we're so pro.
Exactly. Super pro.
You guys are welcome for that professionalism. Take it for what it is, right?
Exactly. That's what you get around here. Yeah. Professionalism.
Boom.
Look at all these saplings I have. Should probably put some of these buckets over here. Or barrels.
I wasn't going to say anything, but...
and get some dirt. Get the cobble going.
Nice.
Also, I've got some rotten flesh we can use.
Oh, really?
I do.
Cool. Nice. All right. Almost there. Lob. Ooh, 800. Almost there. Now, once we got this, we'll go AFK. We'll get a whole bunch of cobblestone. And then at that point, then we're going to be just grinding the sieves, right?
Yeah, we'll be grinding the sieves, and we'll kind of be organizing, making things look and set up the way we kind of want them to.
Nice.
Off camera.
Yeah. And then
that way once.
And then I want to, by the end of the next episode, have for us auto cobble creator. So you can actually
that sounds awesome.
You can use a transfer node, which I'll show you guys next episode. And then you use a world modifier, which includes using or putting in the transfer node, and it automatically creates cobblestone for you. It's amazing.
It is amazing.
All right, sir, we are counting down. Almost there. And so you think we'll have some farms by next episode as well?
I certainly will. We'll have a couple farms up and going.
Okay.
So we can have a space just to do this grinding for the trees.
Nice.
And a space for the food. We'll see what all seeds we get. Potato seeds are my favorite.
I figure it's going to be boring to just do a vanilla AFK mod or mob drop.
Yeah.
So I'll just do that off camera as well. Is it time?
Oh, yeah. It's look time. What we got. Boom.
Here we go.
I have a bucket of lava.
Life.
And I'm going to go.
Is now good, sir.
Pour it right there and run away.
We have it.
Yay! We have a cobble generator.
Awesome. Woo! Now, I am going to go ahead and switch this one right here out for obsidian. I'm going to go make some more lava. We'll put some obsidian right there. And then I can just do my AFK stuff where I'm just automatically farming. And I won't actually walk away from it, but we'll have that to go on as well. So we got a lot of stuff ahead of us, sir.
We definitely do.
Cool, man. So I think we'll cut it off there, and we will catch you guys next time. Bye-bye.
See you guys later. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
It is up to you. I think we've got what we need for the furnace for sure.
Well, we'll need some of it, right, for the getting gravel and sand?
Yes, we will.
Okay. So this will be a bunch of a grind to get the cobblestone going for this, but